When encryption fails, it's not because of the encryption algorithms. Our AES 128s, our even our 3DES, these are incredibly secure algorithms, right? And they've withstood the test of time. They've withstood academic intrusions. They've withstood all the things. When encryption fails, it's because key management fails. And so key management is invariably, you talk to anybody who has any experience with protecting data through encryption, and it always comes down to key management. One of the fundamental principles of managing encryption keys effectively is to establish a key rotation period. Now, that is most often thought of in terms of time. Is it annual? Is it quarterly? Is it every 5 years? What's our originating use policy? What's our recipient usage policy? There's some material out there from NIST in the NIST 800 series, NIST 800-88, that speaks to all of these different things around key management and key rotation. One of the most fundamental things to understand about rotating encryption keys is that the principal matter, the principal source for determining our rotation period is quantity of data. As the number of bytes of data increase that we've encrypted to a single key, the possibility that two blocks of data, that two messages, that two files could produce the same encryption, the same encrypted result, could that increases over time. So as our quantity of data increases, it's necessary for us to then rotate the key. Now, there are some recommendations out there that you can tease out of some of the academic articles that you can pull out of some of these different sources. But Kirkpatrick Price, in recommending to our customers, based on the sensitivity of the data, the longevity, the security life of the data, that probably lies somewhere between 64 gigabytes and 1 terabyte of data encrypted to a single key using an AES-based algorithm. Now, that may sound like not a lot of data. And there are certain cases, for instance, in whole drive encryption and the algorithms and the methods that are used in that we may see up to 16 terabytes of data encrypted to a single key. But it is necessary to consider the overall quantity of data encrypted to a single key as part of your key rotation schedule.